So we will discuss today about this upward fixation of patella and sting halt. Sometimes sting halt is also used as a upward fixation of patella, but sting halt is entirely different and upward fixation of patella is different. Sign symptom is also different. Surgical correction is also different, right? So what happens, what clinical sign you will observe in animal suffering from this upward fixation of patella? This due to upward fixation of patella, animal is not able to fold this stifle joint, hock joint, but this fetlock joint is flex. So the animal suffering from upward fixation of patella having a extended hock joint, extended stifle joint, but flex fetlock joint. So the condition may be either in one limb or in both limb. This condition is only restricted to the hind limb only, right? And the severity of the condition is varies from mild to moderate or severe, or maybe unilateral or bilateral. That means in one limb, one hind limb, or in both hind limb. So in this three video, I would like to explain the severity and also the unilateral and bilateral also. So later on we will play video. Okay, so the condition is hyperextension of this hock joint and a stifle joint and flexion of the fetlock joint. Animal is normally healthy. There is no any temperature, and the complaint by the owner is while walking for some distance, animal started normal walk. Okay, but while sitting in the morning after overnight rest, sometimes the animal is not able to drag the affected limb and not able to fold this joint. This type of complaint you will get from the owner. So if this clinical sign symptom you will get, most of the chances is upward fixation of patella, right? So this condition is most common in cattle or horse also. So what are the predisposing causes behind this problem? Occupational trauma. Sometimes the bullocks are used for the in the cart or plowing. And laxity of the ligament due to some stretching or stretching of the limb due to when animal kept in uneven surface. And climatic condition, the severity of the clinical sign is more in winter season as compared to the this summer, or we can say rainy season. And pregnancy also, because during pregnancy, due to influence of the progesterone, the patella ligament get somewhat relaxed, so there is a frequent chances of locking. So what happens here, the patella get fixed over the medial trochlear ridge, medial side, okay, medial trochlear ridge of the femur by hooking the medial fibrocartilage of the patella. Actually, on medial side of the patella, there is a wing of this a small protrusion of the fibrocartilage part that while gliding, it get fixed over the medial trochlear ridge of femur. So this is the location of the stifle joint. Okay. So how we locate the stifle joint, or we can explain here better. So this one is the patella. Okay, this one is the patella which attached with the tibia with three ligament. This one is tibial tuberosity. So this one is a lateral side and this one is the medial side. So this one is lateral patellar ligament, this one is medial patellar ligament, and this one is medial patellar ligament. So this one is a medial trochlear ridge of the femur, and here the medial fibrocartilage of the patella. So it get hook over this area. So our purpose of doing surgery is, if we cut this medial patellar ligament, it will get relaxed, and it starts gliding over the trochlear ridge, right? Because once the patella get fixed over here, then only the animal is not able to fold the hock joint or even the stifle joint, right? So this is the video I will play later on, how to locate this medial patellar ligament. So next is a location, because our target of surgery is this medial patellar ligament. Okay, so how we locate this medial patellar ligament in live animal, right? So now you see here, you start sliding your finger from this cranial aspect of the tibia and go upward, you will find one elevation, that is a tibial crest. Now you see, I will proceed from here to here, then I will get this prominent area, that is a tibial crest. From tibial crest, further you move one or two finger upward, then you will get thick ligament, and this ligament is medial patellar ligament, medial, right? Then you have to slightly move towards the medial side, then you will get feel one depression. This depression is in between the medial patellar ligament and medial patellar ligament. So further, if you roll your finger over this medial patellar ligament, then you can able to assess the thickness of medial patellar ligament, right? So this is how we can able to locate this medial patellar ligament. So restraining, for performing this surgery, we can perform either in a standing condition or in lateral recumbency. So for further in lateral recumbency, either we can keep the affected limb down. Suppose if the right hand limb is affected, then we can cast the animal with right lateral recumbency, that means right side down. Or second is, we can also keep this right hand limb on upside, or we can say the left lateral recumbency. Each recumbency or restraining position have advantages and disadvantages. Or third is, also we can operate this condition in a standing condition. And if the animal is furious and not cooperative, then in that case we can use this chemical restraining, or we can restrain the animal by giving some chemicals like this xylazine, that is a 5 mg intravenous per cow or per buffalo, will help us to induce a mild sedation in the animal, and we can restrain it properly. Or we can also use this butorphanol. Either we can go for 2 mg or 2 to 4 mg intravenous per cow per buffalo. One thing we have to remember here is, if we use xylazine, we must rule out the pregnancy, because the xylazine in advanced stages of pregnancy in cattle and buffalo induce abortion. So in that case, we have a choice of butorphanol, right? So this is about the positioning or restraining while operating the animal. So similar condition in case of cow also. So now see, first you proceed here and go to the tibial tuberosity, then try to locate this medial patellar ligament, move medially, try to locate this medial patellar ligament. So this is the site of your surgery. Now what you have to do is you have to apply the alcohol and betadine to make this area aseptic. Then you insert one needle in this groove, that is in between this medial and medial patellar ligament, and inject 5 ml to 10 ml 2% lignocaine. Wait for 10 to 15 minutes at least, so that this particular area get desensitized. Now you have to operate it. Then for operation, what we have to do here, we can cut, our target is to cut this medial patellar ligament at distal end, because if we move proximally, there may be chances that we may enter inside the stifle joint. So we prefer to cut at the distal end, right? So we can cut this ligament either by using 11 number blade, 12 number blade, or we have a tenotomy bisturi. Okay, tenotomy bisturi, right? So what we have to do here, we insert our bisturi just below this ligament, and after going just below the ligament, we rotate with the sharp edge towards this ligament, right? And just we pull it. And this is after pulling. Once we cut this ligament over here, the patella immediately get free, and immediately animal is started to walk normally. So this one is one of the magic in front of the farmer. So you will get immediate 100% result. So after post-operatively, we just inject 1 or 2 ml betadine at this incision site, and also we give painkiller or some sort of long-acting antibiotics for one time. So that will be enough. So how you assess that this particular medial patellar ligament is you have cut or severed? So what you will observe after cutting this medial patellar ligament over here is, further if you proceed to the tibial tuberosity, then medial patellar ligament, you won't able to locate this medial patellar ligament. You only find a longitudinal, or you can say clear cut depression in this area, right? So depression at the location of medial patellar ligament and cessation of crunching sound immediately relieve the characteristic jerk flexion during progression. So all these signs, if you will observed in the animal, then it indicates that you have successfully operated this animal, right? So this one is video, I will play later on. So next one is a string halt. Okay, the string halt, in that case the problem is located in the ligament, right? But in case of a string halt, is the problem is located in the tendon. Okay, so in that situation, The animal is not able to fold the hock joint or staple joint, but in this situation, in a string halt condition, animal is hyperflexing this hock joint and this canon bone, or we can say metatarsal bone, touches the belly. Hyperflexion followed by extension, right? So this is the characteristic sign you will observe in animal. I will play video. So what we have to do here in case of this string halt condition, this one is a lateral digital extensor tendon, right? And this one is long digital extensor tendon. Okay, now you see here in this figure, this one is lateral digital extensor tendon and this one is a long digital extensor tendon. So the lateral digital extensor tendon, once it crosses to the hock joint on the lateral side, right, it will ultimately, just below the hock joint, it will join with the long digital extensor tendon. So our target of surgery in case of a string halt is this lateral digital extensor tendon. What we do here, we simply make one incision over here and cut this lateral digital extensor tendon at this place. Then I used to pull this part of the ligament from at this level, and we put one incision over here and remove this lateral digital extensor tendon part. So this is the surgical procedure for a string halt. We can operate this condition either under deep sedation and local anesthesia, or we can operate this condition under general anesthesia in equine. Right?
Sir.
Yes.
Sir, इसको एक बार और बोल दीजिएगा.
ये देखो. Sir. Right, yes. Right. Let's see. This one is the lateral side of the limb, right limb, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yes.
Lateral
sir.
Side of the right limb. Then here our target of this surgery is this area. We won't bother about these muscles, these ligaments and tendon, right? I will focus mainly on this. Show this one is lateral digital extensor tendon that after crossing the hock joint, it gets joined with the long digital extensor tendon. This one lateral digital extensor tendon, this one is long digital extensor tendon, right? If you see clearly in this figure, this one is a lateral digital extensor tendon, while after crossing this hock joint, it attaches with the long digital extensor tendon, right? So our target of surgery is this lateral digital extensor tendon. We put one incision over here, okay? Then pull this part from this place outside and remove, after cutting at this place, we can remove this whole part of this lateral digital extensor tendon. This is the all about this surgery in case of a string halt. But as compared to the upward fixation of patella, we won't get immediate result in this condition, though the severity is reduced, or we can say the less severity is there. But for 100% result or 100% correction, the animal may take 6 months to 1 year time, right? So one by one, I would like to show you video.
सर पैटलर डिस्प्लेसमेंट में डिजिटल पार्ट में इंसिजन लगाएंगे, आप फिर प्रोक्सिमल में भी नहीं लगाएंगे तो वो तो लटकते रहेगा, फिर हैंगिंग करते रहेगा,
वो ठीक है। तो एक ही जगह इंसिजन डालना है, उसमें दोबारा नहीं डालना है, निकालने की जरूरत नहीं है उसको, राइट?
वो हैंगिंग करेगा ना सर अंदर में,
कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं होगा उससे, ठीक है?
Okay,
so now you see this, we can also call this string halt operation Bocart's operation or peroneal tenotomy. Now you see this video ओके इज इट विजिबल, ये वीडियो दिख रही है आप लोग को?
यस सर, यस सर.
नाउ यू स्टार्ट फ्रॉम हियर. सो दिस इज द साइट ऑफ दिस वन, राइट? आई हैव होल्डिंग दिस लैटरल डिजिटल एक्सटेंसर टेंडन. आई एम होल्डिंग हियर, राइट, एट दिस प्लेस. And this is the place where this lateral digital extensor tendon get attached with the long digital extensor tendon. So just you watch this video and you will see here, you will see here, once I apply pressure over here, now you see there is a tension is there, right? So this one is, so after pulling, if there is a tension in this tendon, now I cut this. This is a cadaver. Okay, so after pulling proximal, right? 8 minutes. Now you see here. So this surgery I have performed on cadaver. So what we have to do here is we have to cut at the distal end and just pull from the proximal end. Okay, and again we have to remove from this place. And finally, we apply suture at this place and this place. So this is all about this string halt operation. And now you see what clinical signs shown by the animal suffering from a string halt. Now you see there is a hyperflexion of the hock joint, hock and a stifle joint. Hyperflexion, that means this metatarsal bone. Metatarsal bone is directly touching the belly. Okay, this is not a condition in case of upward fixation of patella. Okay, it is clear. Now you see this surgery also. This one is a live surgery. Here distal part is exposed. Now proximal to the hock joint also is able to pull. Now you see. So finally we have to cut over here and just pull from at this place and remove. Okay, he's separating this lateral digital extensor tendon at the proximal aspect of the hock joint. So now you see, now he is cutting at the distal place, distal end, right? And he will pull from this place, pull it out from this place. Now you see. Now you see, yes, he's trying to pull outside. Yes, and finally he will remove from this place. Okay. So this is all about the surgery of this resting hall. Okay. So next one is, now you see upward fixation of patella. Okay. Now you see in this condition, okay, wait. Now you see this video. Here the problem is bilateral. So in this condition, this animal is not able to flex this hock joint and a stifle joint, only folding of this fetlock joint. So there is a problem is in bilateral. Okay. Now you see this condition. Now you see this one, in case of horse, in all condition, animal is not able to fold this hock joint. Okay, see from the back side. Now see, okay, now this one is problematic video, okay. So next one is a, you see this one, same cow having a bilateral problem. One limb is operated. That means this left hind limb has been operated. Left hind limb is now get normal now. Right one is still dragging. Okay. Now you see this video, both hind limb is operated and immediately how animal started walking. Okay. So you will get immediate result. Now same condition you will see here in case of this equine. This horse having a problem in right hand limb, upward fixation of patella. Now you see this one is a before surgery, and now you see same horse after surgery. So you will get immediate result, 100% result, once you able to perform correctly. So this is all about the upward fixation of patella and the string hold. Here I would like to show you that sometime animal is walk few steps in a normal manner or normal walk, and thereafter once the patella get fixed over the medial condyle of the medial, not condyle, medial trochlear ridge of the femur, then it get locked and started dragging the limb. You will see this condition in this video. So let him go outside. Now you see, the animal is not working normally. Okay, this is working, this curve is working normally. Now you see, once the patella gets stuck over this cochlear, now you see how the joint get extended and animal find difficulty in moving forward. Okay, so this is all about the string halt and upward fixation of patella. In conclusion, I would like to tell you that in case of upward fixation of patella, there is a hyperextension of this hock joint, and surgical procedure is medial patellar desmotomy, that we you say MPD, medial patellar desmotomy. And this surgery in Western country also they use to tell this surgical procedure as BASI method. Okay, while in case of a string halt, there is a hyperflexion of the hock and a stifle joint with the cannon bone touching the belly. So in this condition, the surgical procedure is lateral digital extensor tenotomy. In that case, we cut this ligament. In case of upward fixation of patella, we used to cut the ligament. Here we used to cut the tendon. The surgical procedure is for peroneal tenotomy here, and in that case, medial patellar desmotomy in case of this upward fixation of patella. This is all about today's class. Thank you.
अवेला रहेगा तो कर लेंगे
सर। अब आप क्या अपवर्ड फिक्सेशन ऑफ पटेला या फिर रेस्टिंग हॉल्ट का केस डायग्नोस कर लोगे?
यस सर, यस सर,
यस सर।